Jonathan Blake. I'm Technical Director of Crop Protection within ADAS. I'm based over in Herefordshire, where we have a range of field trials looking at efficacy of products on Septoria specifically, but we have sites elsewhere in the country looking at other diseases. Yeah, now we've pulled a few plants up today and we found actually the leaves at the moment look quite clean. Top three or four leaves don't have a lot of visual disease, but we suspect underneath there's actually underneath the surface there there's a lot of infection that has occurred in this wet period we've just had, and that actually what we will see in 10 days from now will be lesions on those leaves where we can't see them yet.
So my name's Phil Bounds and I'm a senior research scientist based at ADAS Rosemond, and I manage a range of cereal fungicide trials across the UK. And as you can see, we've got the typical Herefordshire rainfall, which is making it quite wet. And we run sites across the country, so we tend to focus the rust trials in the east of the UK at our sites there. And then we tend to use the west and the southwest of the UK for testing on Septoria triticide, where we generally get high Septoria pressure from the high rainfall that we see.
Within any of those given years that we've been looking at Univoq over the last 7 or 8 years, we've typically been testing Univoq in protectant and curative situations, as well as looking at it in mixtures with other chemistries and looking at timings to see when it can best be used. We've also looked at its persistence and degree of protection through the season.
We've seen it to be an effective T1 product. We've also tested it extensively at T2 and in a range of situations and a range of timings. And we've seen it to be a very effective product when applied at T2. So when we tested Univoq in a high pressure situation in Santiago in Herefordshire, we saw a significant reduction in the Septoria level on leaf one compared with the SDHIAzole. And that translated into a significantly higher green leaf area level. And when we looked at the yield data for that, we saw an increase in yield from applying the Univoq, and this increase in yield ranged from 0.5 tonne up to 1.5 tonnes per hectare. In a year with a prolonged grain filling period when the crops held on and really filled those grains, the persistency of Univoq has really stood out in terms of green leaf area retention as the season has progressed, and it really has drawn it away from other products as the season has progressed.
For the last 15 or so years, we've been relying on two modes of action for the control of Septoria in wheat. We've been relying on SDHIs more recently, but the azoles as well. In support, we've also had the multi-site fungicides. This, though, is a step into a new sphere, if you like. It's another mode of action, which will improve the resilience of our programs, both in the long term, but also potentially in the short term. And that's really valuable. That gives us a greater resilience. It means that we have more ability to guard against any shift in efficacy that could occur. And that could occur this year, it could occur in 5 years. We're not quite sure how long it will take to occur, but that shift is something we can guard against now. We'll be continuing to test Univoq over the next few years because although it's now available and has been launched, efficacy of all fungicides tends to change over time, and we'll be tracking how it compares in terms of efficacy with other modes of action to see just how it continues to compare and what the best choices are for farmers.